Let's do this stuff. Oh my goodness. The music's on. Let me turn that off. Okay. This is Sahara Drak, sclegacy.com, and today I'm bringing you a Terran vs. Terran on the map Lost Temple from the full retail release of StarCraft II between Satini, a well-known Terran player, and Preddy, another very well-known European Terran player. So yeah, should be exciting stuff. Again, I have not seen this game because I prefer to not watch the results before I cast. Just makes everything a little more fun, I feel. So, StarCraft II is out. The campaign makes me feel like I'm in 10th grade again. There's only one way to say it, and like it doesn't really convey it properly, but it's just StarCraft. Like, it feels like StarCraft. Like, you're like, I am playing the sequel to StarCraft. I'm not playing some other game with the name on it, you know? So, very, very cool. Campaign's really fun. I've beaten like 6 missions, nothing too intense, but you know, I've also been playing a lot of team games. I played a lot of team games after the midnight release because all my friends were on and stuff, so. Yeah, and a barracks going down on 12 here, and similarly, a barracks at 12 in Satini, neither player opting to wall in, which I think is a very smart move in TVT. I'm sure y'all know why, because then you put the dang supply depots in the bunkers or barracks here, and then the siege tank just right here, boom, you know. So yeah. Don't wall off in TVT, it's not worth it. Because they're not going to be Marine rushing you. I mean, like, maybe 1 in 50 games someone will Marine rush you. And, you know? So, just not worth... The juice is not worth the squeeze. So, we got a SCV coming up here. He's going to scout... Preddy is going to scout Satini first. And find out they're going to find out they're both in close positions. Because Satini can pretty much gather he came from either here... Oh, pings don't work in replays. Well, here or here. So, and also, Satini has his SCV in the base, so they both scouted correctly right away. So yeah, StarCraft II is out, and I have my cool Diablo Marine portrait. So badass. And I have cool Diablo skull on all my Terran buildings. It's pretty awesome. And I don't know if you guys watched Day 9's Launch Party Netcast last night. It was a lot of fun. You know, I got in a wee bit of trouble, but, you know, my style is uncompromising, and that's why you guys like me, so I'm not ashamed. So, yeah, anyways. Pretty moving down here to the Zelnaga Watchtower, and I actually think the first person to get vision of this Zelnaga Watchtower gains a lot of momentum moving into the game, because you see he can move that SCV, and first he establishes basically the push, the overall flow of the troops in the game. Even though they have the same troops, looks like Preddy's Marine was a little late, but you see, because Preddy can see them coming, he's able to get the jump on these guys. And good micro there, ooh. Pulls the Marine back with 3 hit points and maintains control of the Zelnaga Watchtower. In the meantime, the factory is just finishing, and Marauders and Concussive Shell coming out for, and a Hellion coming out for Preddy. So it looks like we're going to see, probably when this Hellion finishes, a neat little push with some Marines, a Hellion, and a Marauder. In the meantime, just 3 Marines going down here. Factory also making a Hellion and opting for a Starport. So, might see some Tank Viking stuff. Might not. I don't know. Remains to be revealed. So, here comes that Hellion. And there he is. I missed my 3D portraits, but it really affected the frame rate when I was recording this, so no more 3D portraits for me to do voice acting for, unfortunately. This Hellion does a little sneak by here. He's able to get up the ramp. He's going to see exactly what Preddy's up to, and probably get some SCV kills because there's nothing to defend it at all. We'll keep an eye on this Hellion. In the meantime, establishing his little push here at the base of the ramp, and he's going to push up here. There is a bunker. It does deflect him right away. He's not even going to try. 2 kills for the Hellion. SCVs are fighting. And yeah, this Hellion has had free reign. And there's the Marauder. Gonna put an end to that monkey business. But 3 kills for a scouting Hellion. Can't argue with that. That's like a little gift. So, switching to the tech labs. Start making some tankaroos. And, I don't know if you guys know about tankaroos, but tankaroos are more powerful than tanks because they have... Oh, wow. Where's this armory? Look at that. Preddy hid the armory so well, he even hid it from me. So, a food blocked Thor coming out. I don't blame him. Thors are always surprising with how much food they cost. You're like, really? 22 food per Thor? Okay, well, I guess I better start making some supply depots. So, yeah. Missile turret going down because he did see the starport earlier when he scanned, I guess. Or he scouted it. I don't know. I didn't quite catch it. Banshee coming out. Cloak being researched? Yes, absolutely. And there's the tankaroos. So we're going to see a pretty, like, your staple mix. Well, I don't know if I'd ever call Banshees in a mix staple, but we'll see if he uses them as an army composition or as a harass unit. Probably a harass unit. And right as I say that, this Banshee is coming in. He's got two SCV kills. And this, being one of the SCVs, doesn't get that missile turret finished. This one is done so that this Banshee's not going to, like, end the game or anything. But it is definitely going to cause some serious issues. How much energy? Do you have enough energy for a scan here? No starport, so the Viking instantly ends Banshee harass, but unfortunately he doesn't have a starport. So going through, that's a pretty smart move going for this supply depot, because that's a big bad supply depot. It's worth a lot of food. And the Thor does manage to take out the big vision range on that missile turret, because the scan definitely did not go down. So good move, good play from Preddy there, getting that Thor out in time. Unfortunate for Satini that he was just in that turret's vision range. So expansion getting established here for our blue friend Satini, and another factory and another starport with a reactor going down. Oh no, same starport. He's putting the factory on the tech lab. So we're going to see three factories and one starport for Satini. And there's the expansion for Preddy. Seeing more Terrans opt to just expand at the natural rather than build it and float it over, I'm not sure why. Scan goes down and quickly takes care of that Banshee. It looks like Satini's going to stop with the Banshee action. And it looks like Preddy did not buy StarCraft II Collector's Edition, because his Thors are plain old boring vanilla Thors. Me, I've got cool Gundam anime Thors. So, that's okay. I do, the collector's edition is so cool. Oh my god. It's like the sleekest thing I've ever seen. The art book is classy. Pure class. Definitely recommend checking it out. I haven't watched the DVD yet. I'm excited about that too. So tanks, a little low on money. Vikings and a tank coming out. I'm not sure. I mean, yeah, I guess. I'm trying to logically reason why opt for Vikings in this stance instead of Banshees, because at least Banshees can hit the ground. They still give your tanks just as much vision, and they still die just as much. Two Thors, and you already spent the money on cloak. So, you know, I definitely opt for Banshees for my tank vision in this option, because you really only need one, you know. But he is going to start doing his slow push out towards the middle, and Terran vs. Terran is a very cool matchup. I used to kind of hate it because of the Viking tank thing, but as it evolves and people break out of that stuff, I love seeing the territorial battles and whatnot over the middle. It looks like this tank is going to get caught unawares and get taken out by the Thors while he's sieging, unfortunate for Satini. But,